Hey everybody, it's Rachel here with Two Ears Are Better Than One, and today I'm going to do a quick video tutorial on using the Advanced Bionics new AB Remote mobile app for the new Marvel processors. So without further ado, let's get okay, so let's get into this. Just to let you know, if you're trying to use the AB Remote app, it is, if you look at the bottom corner here, you'll see AB Remote. That's what you'll look for, you'll search for on either the Play Store or the Apple, whatever the Apple Store is. So you tap on that once you get it downloaded. And the first thing that you're gonna have to do is actually pair your devices with the app. So the first step with this is, and it actually tells you how to restart your devices. It's simply opening up the pairing window by removing the battery from the processor and putting it back on. That opens the pairing window to allow you to pair to an app or anything Bluetooth essentially. So I've done that. I click on connect. And then it's gonna search for the processors. As you can see, my first one popped up, which is my right, and it's got both my right and my left now. I'm gonna click connect. You see the LE underscore, that indicates that it's a low energy Bluetooth connection, which is specific to the app. So now I'm connected, I'm going to hit continue, and we'll just kind of go through some of the options that are available here. So this first window that you're going to see, at the top you'll see the AB remote, you'll see which program you're currently on with the little drop down chevron there. This shows you the programs that are available right now. So I have my AutoSense OS 3.0. I have my old Everyday program that we had loaded just because I wanted to be able to have my kind of backup in case I didn't like the AutoSense OS. And then I also have my off-ear compatible program. I can check and change to any of those just by tapping on them. And it allows me to switch the programs really quickly and easily through the app. This is your volume slider here. Now it adjusts both of them at the same time. I can also split it though. So if I want to adjust my right ear or my left ear, I can adjust that and I can put it back together. You'll see the battery status up there. It essentially goes 100%, 75%, 50%, 25%, and then I think it goes 10 and 5 and maybe 2 before it completely dies on you. You'll see a little cog wheel up at the top that is for additional options. And sorry, it's hard for me to tap this. There we go. So this gives you additional options for the app. You have your app settings, my devices, app settings, really, there's not a whole lot that you'd want to do with there. So basically where you want to focus on is, sorry, it's really hard for me to tap this, is my devices. And so under my devices, you'll have my programs. This is a list of programs that are available. They may not all be accessible at the moment. You'll see any program that is added by your audiologist will be up at the top, but then you'll also see TV connector, Roger Direct Plus mic, partner mic, and then Bluetooth streaming. Now, each of these, you can actually change the name of the program. So because I have two phones, if you look at the bottom there, you'll see Bluetooth streaming, and it says Samsung, and it says iPhone. Those I created the name for. Otherwise, it just says Bluetooth streaming. Because I have my processors connected to my iPhone, and I have my processors connected to my Samsung phone. This just allows me to see in an instant what I'm connected to. Not such a big deal because on the Bluetooth, you really know what you're connected to. It's not like you can connect to something unknowingly, but what I really like is for the TV connector. So the TV connector, I actually have two TV connectors, and you have the capability of being connected to two TV connectors. And if you are in range of both of those two TV connectors, by changing the name of them, and you simply change the name by clicking the little chevron and then the pencil, you can change the name, and then once you've named it whatever you want it to be, then you'll be able to choose which option you want to be focused on, or which program you want to be connected to. So I'll give you a little example here. I'm going to fire up my TV connector because I have it here. And you'll see as soon as my TV connector starts streaming, the option for that program pops up. So there you go. So now I have my office TV connector. It's connected here. This allows me to decide, okay, I don't want to listen to what's coming through my TV connector right now, so I want to go back to AutoSense. You can tap on that. But let's say I want to stay on my TV connector. You get another option that pops up here. So at the bottom, you'll see just below the split, there's another little thing that pops up. This allows you to control your balance, your environmental balance between what is being streamed through the device, whether it's a TV connector, Bluetooth, partner mic, Roger, etc. You can adjust the balance of your environmental sounds and the streaming signal. So right now I'm getting about an equal amount coming from the TV connector and from my microphones. But let's say somebody comes in, start talking to me. I can adjust this by sliding that balance down. Now I hear nothing coming from the TV connector and I hear all of my environment around me. But let's say it's a really noisy environment and I don't want to hear what's happening around me. I can slide this back the other way. And now I'm hearing almost completely the TV connector. I can still hear a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of environmental sounds, but it's very limited. And so you can really, really fine tune this with the app anywhere in between. And you find your balance that you like. This can also be done through the processor. So if you are in a streaming signal and you want to adjust the balance and you want to hear the streaming signal more than the environmental balance, you're just going to do a short press on the multifunction button up. You'll see the little app indicator move over as it increases. So each press is just a little bit of a jump. If I want to focus more on the environmental sounds, I push down on that, and you'll see it just kind of pops down as I go. So this gives me the flexibility to be able to really listen how I want to listen, and I absolutely love this feature. So if we go back to the little cog wheel there, you can go back to my devices. So we looked at my programs. Now we're going to look at statistics. So this will show what my current battery level is, and it also shows me what my average wearing time per day is, which is kind of cool to see, and when you were last seen by your audiologist. If I want to go to adaptive Bluetooth, and this is something that is more for troubleshooting. So if you have some, like when you're making phone calls and people are saying, I'm having a really hard time understanding you, you can try turning adaptive Bluetooth on. I haven't had any issues, so I've just been leaving it off, but that's an option there that you can select if you need to. And then you also have the option to remove the devices if you know, you're having some difficulties with the app or something, it might be necessary to forget the device and then repair again. So aside from my devices, you can go to the help button here. This actually takes you to myabonline.com, which will give you access to all of the different troubleshooting guides and everything. You do have to have your login. So if you don't have an account with AB on myabonline.com, I suggest that you get that set up. And then here's the other really great aspect of this app is the device check. So it gives you the ability to check between left and right devices, and it will tell you whether or not it's locked or not. So you see your battery life. You also see the microphone indicator. So this is going to be related to how much environmental sound is coming in. So if I, you see, as you increase noise, the microphone indicator pops up. So you're seeing how much environmental sounds is being picked up by the microphone. If for some reason that T mic is broken, you will see that the T mic will be grayed out, and that will indicate that the T mic is not functional. If I lose my lock, so I'm no longer locked. The little lock button is now open, and it gives a question mark saying we're not locked. It also gives the ability to play a beep. So I can tap that, and I can hear the processor beep, and I can blink the light, which this allows my processor LED light to flash. Quick tip. If you ever lose your processor in a room and you're not sure what you can't find it, turn out all the lights, launch your app, and then click blink light. It'll flash that light, might make it easier to find in the dark. So anyways, those are the options for checking the device. Now, if you are a newly activated patient and your audiologist has set you up with progressive levels, this is where you will be able to see those progressive levels. I don't have progressive levels, so I can't show them here, but that will appear right below the blink light button, and it will say progressive level, and it will tell you which progressive level you are on, and you will also have the ability to go up or down on your progressive levels there. So that is pretty much everything for the app. I can't think of anything else to share with you at this point. Hopefully that helps you get an idea of what the app can do. One little tip that I have done with my Samsung phone is I have actually programmed my Bixby button to be a quick access. So I can be somewhere, let's just launch Pandora, for instance. So I can be on my, in Pandora or something, and with a simple press of my Bixby button, it launches my AB. Anyways, yeah, that's the app. I hope you got a lot out of this. As always, if you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe. And if you have any comments or questions, shoot them below in the comments section. Thanks for watching. Have yourselves a wonderful day. Till next time.